listen to Count Richard von Coudenhove Kalergi. And just over here in the Bell Centre in Darndale, looking at Immanuel Godson, some of his paintings. Extraordinary work here. Isn't that beautiful?
CJ,
across, and the manual sitting in the middle there, and he's also the man with the jester's hat in front of the lion's tea box. And these are pictures of all people from within the local community, bar the kangaroo, which is sitting on the manual's left shoulder. So, and Brennan's bread there. Another piece of art he did. Wonderful piece. Another one there, Brennan's bread. There's something. I like that one there. It says, "Eat water, Ishka. Pay for this and become this." Wonderful stuff.
Some of the things I do, I'm a classical fine arts painter, obviously. I like to do reproductions of the old classics for practice. Some of my other work is more original stuff, but some of the older ones, I'll talk about some of the meanings in the older ones. I have a terrible sense of humour. I'm known for being very controversial sometimes. So some of the works that go over your head sometimes, when they're explained to you, you'll get the jokes. I'd often paint with a really tongue-in-cheek sense of humour, so I'll just explain some of them here. This is one of the first examples of a reproduction, and it's a famous painting of Where the Venus by Boucher. The word Venus is where we get the word venereal disease. Venereal disease is the disease of love, the disease of Venus. So there's kind of a circular meaning going on here that she's actually having a herpes outbreak. So if you get up close, you can see she has a venereal disease. The five-pointed star is the planet Venus, is the only body in the sky, the only planet that goes anti-clockwise, is associated with the lawless one, right? And it's where we get the pentagram. It's like a pentagram anti-clockwise orbit of Venus. So the reason I paint some of my paintings, I'm going to pull one out from the back in a minute because it talks about, it touches on prophecy in art history. It's like some of the works in art history are prophetic, they're well ahead, years ahead of their time, that they only come into play in our times now. You know, some of these paintings are hundreds of years old and they're only relevant now. When I seen this is a Bougeroo painting, and when I seen it, I says that's O'Connell Street, that's the Roma family begging on O'Connell Street today in Dublin. So what I did was I elaborated upon the idea and Dublinified the scene. Right, so it's like up around Central Bank there, there's a Roma family begging. Now that middle section is just a reproduction of what Bougeroo painted. And then I elaborated upon the idea. Some of the references that we put in is we found that the Roma community with their aggressive begging, it was found in a news report, in a news night or something, that they were sending, one family sent 38,000 euro through Western Union back home. I mean, it's a business for them. There's other things. It goes off on little tangents here or there. The homeless man, his feet are just sticking in. You don't see who he is because he's totally anonymous, and that's dedicated to the man who died up outside the door, he froze to death. When we came to the news reports, they would only say that he was a cavern man in his 40s. They wouldn't even mention his name. He was so anonymous and so faceless that that's why I put him under the bank, the drink link. He's beneath the money system. He's completely off the radar. Despite spotlight is on the Roman community with this expose they did in the newspapers on the Roman community. I'm begging the question, why didn't they turn the camera to this fella who's about to die? You know, it's because he was an Irish man. There's a lot to be said about that. It's part of my own experience as well. Well, that's a long story, I won't tell that. But I met a guy, the boots have no laces. I met a guy destitute on the street and I tried to help him. I didn't realise at the time that the reason he had no laces, he was just dismissed from a psych ward or a police station or something. He was on drugs and everything. I tried to help him, but it backfired on me. The twist on it was a joke in it to be had. And the original is called St. Francis of Assisi in Ecstasy. That's the original painting. But my version is called St. Francis and Assisi on Ecstasy. Samsung the phone, and Mary is holding a mobile phone, a Samsung phone, and the angels are playing along to the jingle to get Christ asleep. And the scene was there's litter all around the ground. There's a lion bar and King Crisp wrappers, and right in the corner there's a lighting cigarette, and it's as if somebody was just there and lit them really quickly when you see Christ coming. Right, so. Someone with corruption of voice, I wonder who that was. Right, so it's safe. When I talk about being such a rich and important man to many, you know, he can make miracles happen for people. Just by landing a wink, they become millionaires overnight with their art. And he's the man that does it. So I can imagine that even the fact from this fellow would instill an encore from the people. Because I am, it's like the community is getting around. Getting around me and encouraging me and celebrating me, that's how I felt. So I put myself in the middle. There's a couple of signifiers there. It's a confession that I put a broken piggy bank beside me. All the paraphernalia beside me represent something about myself. So I put a broken piggy bank there to say, to convey the message, I can't save a thing. I'm not able to save. I'm not the real Christ, right? It's only a mock Christ, it's only a pretend Christ, so I'm not blaspheming. Also with the King Crisps, I often use the King Crisps to represent Christianity being the King. So it's turned upside down, so I'm turning the idea of the King on the head. They're just subtle little messages in the visuals. And of course, me being schizophrenic, I put myself with fruitcake and bananas, you know, surrounding me. So I'm famous for painting the bread and spread in the local area. The people love the bread and spreads, their lives. So we put them in, and it's just a gesture that all the homely, familiar food that's on the table, that's the welcome you'll get in the Bell Centre. You know, it'll make you feel very at home, wouldn't it? I'd say so, yeah. So you have Mikado biscuits there, Maltana, which I love.
Yeah.
And all that.
What's the kangaroo, Emmanuel? Oh, you don't want me asking.
The kangaroo is it's chocolate biscuits, isn't it? What?
Chocolate
biscuits. What chocolate biscuits? No, no. Can you see the kangaroo?
Oh, yeah.
See the kangaroo beside me?
Oh, yeah, okay, yeah.
Right, so the kangaroo is a nod of respect to the Monty Python team. That Monty Python did a famous sketch about Michelangelo. He was pitching an idea to the Pope who got very frustrated. Michelangelo was proposing to paint 26 disciples and even a kangaroo in the Last Supper. Right, that's why he didn't get the commission.
Go for it.
God save Ireland.
Thank you, Grand Torino. Three.
God save Ireland.